and Hellenism is, in general, loses its identity. We also focused on the 600 billion that Artemis Sorras brought in favour of the sovereign democracy of Hellas, in contrast with the private corporation called Hellenic Republic, because the sovereign democracy of Hellas is the people themselves. Now, in today's program, we will focus on recent events, and this event is in regard to the national elections of 2019. This was on 7th of July, which was a couple of weeks ago. And we'll focus on the fraud and the theft that happens in the entire voting process and in the election process. We see that through this program, we'll see that all political parties are really one, and their main mission is to divide the people. That's why they are called komata, komatiazun. They divide the people. And they're all involved in the fixed results of the elections. ELLINON SYNELEYSIS and the political body ELLINON SYNELEYSIS partook in these national elections for the first time, both in the European elections and the national elections. The European elections were about 2 months ago, and the national elections were 2 weeks ago. Therefore, we will look into these elections, and the interesting thing to note and to raise, and this should raise a lot of questions to the people, is that Artemis Sorras himself was a political candidate in both the European elections and the national elections. Now, in order to be a political candidate in such elections, you have to have a clean criminal record. Therefore, in contrast to this, we see that Artemis Sorras is currently held in prison. He's held detained with no charges against his name. This should raise a lot of questions for everybody out there. We also see various evidences revealing the fraud and the theft of the election process, the fixed results. And first, the first video that we'll look at is in regard to how the ballot box originated in Greece and the roots of the ballot box. Let's have a look at the first video.
Καταστείτε τώρα ένα καθεστώς το οποίο συνεχώς έχει μια τεράστια δυναμική, γιατί από τότε που έχει τις εκλογές στο νεότερο κράτος, δηλαδή έχει μπει κάλπη, έχουν στήσει την κάλπη από τότε που τελικά δεν είχες κράτος. Ήσουν ήδη υποδουλωμένο. Και όταν λες το 1821 απελευθερώθηκα, μπήκες κατευθείαν στον Όθωνα, δηλαδή στους χαζάρους, δηλαδή στην εκκλησία, και σου φορέσανε καπέλο για αυτή τη διαδικασία και σου φτιάξανε την κάλπη και δίθεν ψηφίζεις και δεν ψήφισες ποτέ και σου έβγαζαν αυτοί πάντα ό,τι ήθελαν. Και είπα, δεν έχει συσταθεί βουλή σε σώμα ποτέ από την πρώτη φορά που συστήθηκε σε κράτος το νεότερο κράτος μας. Ψάχτε πίσω μέχρι το 1841. Δεν θα δείτε ποτέ ότι η βουλή έχει συσταθεί σε σώμα. Άρα δεν υπάρχει καμία αληθινή ψηφοφορία. Άρα δεν υπήρχε ποτέ καμία αληθινή κυβέρνηση. Παρακαλώ, ψάχτε όλα τα ΦΕΚ μέχρι πίσω. Μπείτε στο εθνικό τυπογραφείο στα ΦΕΚ και ψάχτε να δείτε πότε η Βουλή συστήθηκε σε σώμα. Δεν συστήθηκε ποτέ. Μα ποτέ. Τι η Βουλή που έκαναν εκλογές. Θα συσταθεί σε σώμα. Και ο νόμος είναι ξεκάθαρος. Λέει, έπειτα από 28 μέρες μετά από την εκλογή, θα πρέπει η Βουλή να συσταθεί σε σώμα.
So from this video we see that the ballot box was introduced just after 1833 under the rule of the Bavarian and Khazar King Otto. Before this we actually had a transparent voting system, and this was introduced by Kapodistrias. Now Kapodistrias was a very known figure during the War of Independence. He actually united the divided municipalities into a true democracy. Now democracy means the power of the municipalities, το κράτην του δήμου. And this is where the people could actually vote and had the power. And of course this voting of the citizens was transparent and everybody knew who one person voted for. Artemis Sorras mentions that we never actually achieved independence of 1821 and we were actually transferred, the larger powers actually saw that this came through. They saw the devious transfer of the Greek state that was under Ottoman occupation transferred to the Bavarian elite, the Bavarian banking elite specifically. Now, we unfortunately, our war effort relied heavily upon foreign loans, upon the foreign banking regimes, and that gave them the right to take full control of Hellas and of our sovereignty. Now, in this period, we also have the introduction of the first political parties, the first komata, which were the Russian party, the French party, and the English party. Now, there was never any political party for the interests of the Greek citizen, of the Greek himself. Now, these foreign interests, we had foreign interests within our own homeland. Like the parties we have today. Now, divide and conquer has been their main method. And this has been the main method for many years now. Now, once Kapodistrias unfortunately was assassinated, foreign powers took control of Greece through King Otto. King Otto came into power in 1833. And this is the most crucial point in our history, because this is the loss of our identity and our sovereignty. The private corporation Kingdom of Greece was introduced with the introduction of King Otto. And the Kingdom of Greece today is called the Hellenic Republic. We mentioned that the Hellenic Republic is the same private corporation as the Kingdom of Greece of 1833 with King Otto. Now let's have a look at the first fake, and we'll discuss a few things on this fake, because this is the fake that actually turns us from sovereign Hellenes into slaves and subordinates. And this is because every Hellene had to give an oath of subordinacy to King Otto and in the name of the Holy Trinity. We lost our sovereignty and became subordinates in our own country. Now, this is how this ties in with our program today, because after 1833, we have the introduction of the secret ballot. This was introduced after King Otto. And the entire voting process from this point on is fixed, controlled by the elite and the Bavarian families that King Otto brought. Because King Otto, of course, was a 16-year-old kid who came into rule. A 16-year-old kid, of course, cannot rule Greece. He brought a whole lot of families, thousands of Bavarian and Khazarian people. And if we trace the origins of the politicians we have today in our government, we'll see that many of them have traces to these Bavarian families brought in by King Otto. So let's go to today's today's election process, and let's have a look at the next video, which tells us a bit about the statistics involved with the election process and the numbers. Let's have a look at this video.
Σήμερα δηλώνει ο ελληνικός πληθυσμός ότι είναι αυτοί που ζουν στην Ελλάδα αυτή τη στιγμή με τα στοιχεία του κράτους μας, που δεν έχουμε κράτος, είναι ιδιωτική εταιρεία, αλλά το κράτος μας, ότι ζουν 10.050.000 άνθρωποι. Σωστά. Ζουν 10.050.000 άνθρωποι. Θέλω να μου εξηγήσει κάποιος εχέφρον άνθρωπος πώς γίνεται οι εγγεγραμμένοι στους εκλογικούς καταλόγους, που σημαίνει είναι πάνω από 18, είναι 9.990.000.
Δεν μπορεί να το εξηγήσει κανένας αυτό, πρόεδρε.
Άρα έχουμε μια μεγάλη τρύπα εκεί, κανείς δεν ενδιαφέρεται, κανένας δεν μιλάει. Φυσικά δεν υπάρχει κόμμα να μιλήσει, δεν υπάρχει εισαγγελέας, δεν υπάρχει Άριος Πάγος, δεν υπάρχουν συνταγματολόγοι, δεν υπάρχει δικηγόρος, δεν υπάρχει κανένας. Αλλά είναι τεράστιο το μάτριξ που ζούμε. Πώς γίνεται να είμαστε 10.050.000 αυτή τη στιγμή και οι εγγεγραμμένοι στους καταλόγους που βγάζουμε εκλογές είναι 9.900.000. Ακούστε να δείτε, κύριε. Τα 2/3 του πληθυσμού, τα 2/3 είναι κάτω από 18 χρονών και δεν ψηφίζουν. Άρα λοιπόν τα 2/3 είναι
666.
Άρα λοιπόν οι ψηφοφόροι αυτή τη στιγμή, αν ήμασταν 10.050.000, έπρεπε να είναι οι εγγεγραμμένοι στους εκλογικούς καταλόγους για να πάνε να ψηφίσουν τα 6.600.000. Σωστά, κύριε?
Σωστά.
Τα 3.300 είναι παιδιά. Είναι κάτω από 18. Εμείς αντί αυτού είμαστε σε μια Ελλάδα που έχουμε 9.990.000 εγγεγραμμένους για να ψηφίσουν. Άρα λοιπόν έχουμε αυτή τη στιγμή 3.300.000 παραπάνω ψηφοφόρους από αυτούς που δεν πρέπει να υπάρχουν. Ποιοι είναι αυτοί οι ψηφοφόροι? Άρα λοιπόν έχουμε νεκρούς, δηλαδή απαγορεύεται να μου δώσουν τον εκλογικό κατάλογο του κάθε τμήματος.
Now, according to Artemis Sorras, and of course according to the country statistics of 10 million, around 10 million people, a third of the population, which equals 3.3 million people, is under the age of 18, and they of course don't vote and shouldn't be in the electoral register. Therefore, 2/3 of the population should amount to 6.6 million voters who should vote. However, we see that 9.9 million people are written in the electoral register, and Artemis Sorras says, and it's evident, that 3.3 million people, there is extra voters. Now, these are voters who have passed away, according to Artemis, and this can also be proven, and these votes still actually count. Now, the suspicious thing is that it is illegal for anyone to see the electoral register, because if someone was to see the electoral register, they would see that people would be born in 1920s, 1930s, 1940s even, that still vote today in these elections. Even recent deceased people would still vote in these elections. So the regime is able to give many fake identification cards to maybe one person. So to one person that exists as part of the system, or a paid person can be given 10 different identification cards. And with these IDs, he's able to go to 10 different departments and vote under a different name. Because, and this is a fact, this actually happens. So that means that 10 deceased people can actually vote through one living person. And this, and the preceding judge is a person who is in each department where we vote. They are in charge of overlooking the entire process. Their role isn't to monitor or check the identification cards. They simply see the name and mark it off. So this is questionable and suspicious in itself. Let's also see another document which shows the numbers between the national elections and the European elections, which we had before the national elections. And we see that we have a difference of, well, first of all, we see that in the Euro elections we have 10,088,000 people. In contrast with the national elections, which had 9,961,000 people, so we see a difference of 126,607 people. Where do these numbers come from? That's a big difference. And we see again that in the Euro elections we have pretty much the same population amount of Greece. So 10 million people voted, whereas we should have a third of the population under 18 who doesn't vote. And the numbers simply don't make sense. Now let's go through how the election process occurs in Greece so the viewers can have a better understanding of how it occurs. So we have school centres, and in these centres we have departments that are allocated according to alphabetical order of the surnames of the people that vote. So in one centre you could have about 10 departments. Inside each department you have a preceding judge, as I mentioned before, and this is usually a lawyer that is appointed by the borough association. And this preceding judge can also bring a friend with him, which is also very suspicious. We'll get into this. We also have a supervising committee which is drawn by lot of local citizens. Now the problem with this is that in 90% of the voting departments, this amount, the local citizens don't turn up, so you have a supervising committee that's non-existent and that can't control or inspect the voting procedure. In addition to this, we also have the political or the party representatives of each political party. So they send their representatives to various departments to also monitor the voting procedure and make sure there's no injustice in the department. And the preceding judge is in charge of giving the final results from each ballot. So he collects the results from the ballot box after it's counted, to give it to the first instance court, and from the first instance court to the Ministry of Interior. This is where the votes are counted by a private corporation called Singular Logic, and we'll get into what Singular Logic is. And the Ministry of Interior then shows the results live on TV. Now, let's get into the next video, which actually talks about the hidden departments. Let's go to the next video.
Ο Γιώργος ο Παπανδρέου πήγε να ψηφίσει και δεν έβρισκε το εκλογικό τμήμα, σωστά? Τι διάλογο σημαίνει αυτό, αντιλαμβάνεστε?
Καταρχήν, άμα είχαμε τους εκλογικούς, όπως έχεις πει, αντιπροσώπους, θα βρίσκαμε πάρα πολλά τμήματα που είναι δηλωμένα, αλλά δεν υπάρχουν φυσικά.
Έχουμε σε μία πόλη 20 εκλογικά τμήματα ανακοινώσει. Ότι έχουμε 20 εκλογικά τμήματα. Και εγώ αντί για 20 φτιάξω 19. Εσείς πώς θα ξέρετε, πώς θα τα μετρήσετε? Η δυνατότητά σας να μετρήσετε τα τμήματα δεν υπάρχει. Σας έχω πει ότι είναι 20. Στο ΦΕΚ είναι 20 εκλογικά τμήματα και εγώ έχω στήσει 19. Και εκεί μέσα από όλους εσάς δεν θα υπάρχει κανένα όνομά σας για να πάτε. Άρα δεν θα πάτε. Αλλά αφού δεν θα πάτε δεν θα ξέρετε ότι υπάρχει. Που σημαίνει στα 22.600 τμήματα και 500 τμήματα και 600 είναι κρυφά. Τι έχουν μέσα αυτά τα τμήματα? Ψήφους που ουσιαστικά είναι μόνο σε ένα χώρο. Και ρυθμίζονται οι ψήφοι σε ποιο κόμμα θα πάει και ποιον θέλουν να βγάλουν. Είναι έτσι, δεν είναι? Το εκλογικό τμήμα έχει ονόματα μέσα. Το δυστύχημα το μεγάλο είναι ότι ναι μεν έχει το όνομα στο κατάστημα, στο εκλογικό τμήμα, αλλά ο ψήφος δεν έχει υπογραφεί. Που σημαίνει σβήνει το όνομα ότι ψήφισε και εκεί μέσα στην κάλπη υπάρχει ένας ψήφος. Δεν ξέρεις ποιανού είναι και ο νεκρός έχει έρθει και έχει ψηφίσει αφού δεν έχει υπογραφεί. Εσύ δεν μπορείς να το αποδείξεις αυτό, γιατί δεν έχεις 22.600 αντιπροσώπους. Οπότε, εάν αύριο το πρωί είχαμε 22.600 αντιπροσώπους με τις εφεδρίες τους, θα βλέπαμε ποια τμήματα είναι τα κρυφά. Δεν ξέρεις αν έχει 2.000 μάτωμα γεγραμμένα, 3, όσα θέλουν βάζουν ρε παιδί μου, όσα θέλουν, όσα γουστάρουν. Άρα έχουν 500 κρυφά τμήματα που κανονίζουν από εκεί και δίνουν τα ποσοστά στη σύγκυλα.
So here Artemis Sorras talks about the hidden departments that the regime uses in order to count votes. On screen we see the previous Prime Minister of Greece, Papandreou, who couldn't find his department, obviously because it was a hidden department. There's also a case in villages around Greece where extra departments were actually added, even though that actual municipality didn't need more departments because it's a small village. And we see that there are many departments written in Government Gazette because they're obligated to show the amount of departments in the Government Gazette, FEC, which could show maybe 20 departments in a district. However, 19 would be actually established, where one is used to count votes and allocate votes according to who they want as the winner. So these hidden departments, as Artemis says, can amount to probably about 500 to 600 departments altogether. And these are locations where votes are gathered and allocated to who they want as the leading party in governance. Of course, these votes are all dead people, as we mentioned before. There's millions of votes that are people that are deceased, and they add these to the inflated results that we see on television. So the important thing is that the votes are secret, and that helps the regime with its agenda to inflate the results, because we can't cross match the votes that are inside the ballot box with names. It's a secret ballot. The system knows what it's doing. Of course, once, as we mentioned, Singular Logic, and that Singular Logic is a private corporation that is responsible for counting the results from the first instance court and then validates it and lodges the results to the Ministry of Interior. Now, let's have a look at this article that talks about Singular Logic, and we see that Singular Logic, as I said, is a private company and is responsible for counting the votes. Now, previously, we had a Greek company called MIG that was in control of many people with no goodies, that was in control of Everest, for some health hospitals, some the super fast ferries, and including Singular Logic as well. Now, MIG and all of these companies later went to the hands of KKR. Now, if we look up KKR, as mentioned in this article, we will see that the owners are the following. We see that the president of KKR is Jerome Kohlberg Jr., and he is a Jew and an active member of Zionist committees. We also see Henry Kravis, he is the CEO of KKR. He is also a Jew, an active member of Zionist committee, and in various Zionist lobbies. And he's actually also a member of the council of the institution, David Rockefeller. We also have a third person, George R. Roberts, also a Jew, in various Zionist lobbies and over 20 non-profit organizations. Again, we see the problem, if you saw our previous program, of Jewish interests within our own country that exceed the Greek interests. Because we mentioned in our previous program of the Central Jewish Committee, the Kentrico Israelitico Symbolio, KIS, which has direct influence on state mechanisms, including our education system. Now let's go to the next video, which talks about another tactic of the regime, and that is the double departments. Let's go to the video.
Υπάρχουν τμήματα που είναι διπλά. Πώς εσύ θα καταλάβεις ότι είναι διπλό το τμήμα, παιδί μου? Υπάρχει δύο φορές το 235. Στην ίδια περιοχή. Βάλε και άλλα 300 διπλά. Σε όλη την Ελλάδα, τα οποία όλα αυτά έχουν έδρα, ένα γραφείο, ένα εμπόριο και μαζεύουν τους ψήφους, τα συγκεντρώνουν, μαζεύονται μόνο υπογραφές και πάνε στα κατάλληλα πρωτοδικεία.
Here we see yet another tactic of the regime to exaggerate the results. Now here we have double the results because we have double departments. We see that there is another 300 or more departments that are doubled. If we add this to the hidden departments, which amount to probably about 600 departments, we could see over 1,000 hidden and double departments that gather votes and allocate the votes to whoever they want as the winner. Now let's go to the next video, which is another tactic they use that involves the presiding judge The presiding judge, as we said, is the person that overlooks all that overlooks each department allocated by the first instance courts and the bar association. Let's go to the video.
Πάμε τώρα στον εκλογικό αντιπρόσωπο. Ο κάθε δικαστικός αντιπρόσωπος έχει δικαίωμα, λέει, να πάρει μαζί του ένα φίλο του μια φίλη του. Γιατί παίρνει παράδειγμα 150 ευρώ, 200, δεν ξέρω πόσα παίρνει ο άνθρωπος, και βάζει έναν άνθρωπο, του δίνει 30 ευρώ και τον επρίνει για βοηθό. Έτσι δεν είναι?
Έτσι είναι. Έτσι είναι και τα ποσά είναι και μεγαλύτερα, ίσως λες και μικρά νούμερα.
Μπράβο. Άρα λοιπόν παίρνει δύο άτομα δικά του για να ελέγχει το χώρο. Ξέρει εκ των προτέρων ότι από τα 500 άτομα που είναι στο κατάστημά του, στα 600 πόσα είναι, τα 300 είναι νεκρά. Άρα αυτό είναι ψήφι. Αυτή είναι ψήφι εκ του ασφαλούς. Οι πιο καλοί ψήφι είναι. Δεν θα μιλήσουν ποτέ και δεν θα κάνουν ποτέ ένσταση. Το τέλος αφήνει και ένα νουμεράκι και την ώρα που κοιμάται ο εκλογικός αντιπρόσωπος, γιατί τα άλλα, τα κόμματα δεν έχουν εκλογικούς αντιπρόσωπους, είναι όλα μαζί, γιατί είναι όλα του καθεστώτος και θα το εξηγήσουμε και πιο κάτω μετά πώς θα το αποδείξουμε. Οπότε το μεσημέρι που λείπει, καρφώνει 100 ψήφους. Τίποτα δεν είναι. Παίρνει 100 ψήφους, λέτε, τα βάλει μέσα, μπαμπαμπ και τα χώνει στην κάλπη. Δεν είμαστε εντάξει, στο τέλος θα μετρήσεις. Και θα πάει ο δικός μου εκλογικός αντιπρόσωπος τώρα να μετρήσει. Και θα δει ότι στους 500 ψηφίσαν 350 και τα 100 μέσα είναι δικά τους. Ποιος θα τους κόψει? Ποιος θα του μιλήσει? Αφού δεν είναι κανείς εκεί το μεσημέρι, πάω για κατούριμα, λέει. Φτάνει ο χρόνος για κατούριμα να πας, λέει, δηλαδή. Μα σου βάλει 100 ψήφους μας, 150, 120, 80. Και δεν θα βάλει σε όλους δικούς του, θα βάλει εκεί που γουστάρει αυτό. Και εκεί που θα βάλει θα σε κλέψει. Και δεν ξέρεις που θα βάλει.
Now to help us with this specific topic regarding the preceding judge, we're actually going to go to an eyewitness account of a political representative of Ellinon Synelleysis, who was present in the municipality of Sorras. Sorras is a city north of Thessaloniki, and her name is Calliope Altindasioti. Let's go to her video.
Regarding my experience as a political representative of the political body Ellinon Synelleysis, I realized that in the national elections of Greece on July 7th, 2019, a lot of irregularities occurred. In the voting center where I was a political representative, as well as in every voting center, there is a presiding judge appointed by the state who regulates the voting procedure. This presiding judge uses an assistant, and most of the time, this assistant is a relative of his or a friend. I consider that this is one of the first mistakes of the state, because this way nobody can guarantee the validity of the voting procedure. In addition, I noticed, together with other political representatives of the political body Ellinon Synelleysis, that in some voting centers, the number of the voters at a given time was extremely high compared to other voting centers. That actually happened in a voting center that I was responsible to observe during the Greek national elections. In this specific center, there were 100 to 120 more voters at around noontime, compared to the other centers where there were at least 100 voters less at around the same time. Statistically speaking, this is suspicious and made me believe that the presiding judge, together with his assistant, could possibly put 100 ballot papers inside the ballot box before the end of the voting process, which was at 7 p.m., and of course secretly, when no one was watching. However, when I and some fellow political representatives began inspecting this voting center, the presiding judge and his assistant told us that they finally made a mistake regarding the counting of the people who voted. I even noticed in the above-mentioned voting center, where I was a political representative, that there was another political representative from another political party, and this specific representative did not wear a name tag, and she was also helping the presiding judge in the voting procedure. This is very legal, since political representatives are only appointed by the respective political parties and bodies, and their job is to observe and make sure that their respective political party or body is not treated unfairly by the entire voting process. Also, when I asked this specific representative, which political party she represents, she refused to respond and she continued helping the presiding judge. Therefore, after all of this, and everything I and my fellow political representatives of ELLINON SYNELEYSIS witnessed, I realized that during the elections, nobody defends the will of the Greek people. This is something very disrespectful, not only to the Greek people, but also to democracy.
So according to Calliope, the political representative in Ceres of ELLINON SYNELEYSIS, we see that the voting numbers are predetermined. And these predetermined numbers are probably the amount of deceased votes. And all that is left is for the presiding judge, along with the friend they bring along into the department, to place 100 or as many votes as they want, as they have predetermined, into the ballot box, of course, when someone isn't looking. Now, if Calliope obviously wasn't there, they would have done this, but we can say that Calliope's presence caused a bit of confusion in the department, and they couldn't actually put these votes in the ballot box, forcing them to say that we'd actually had extra numbers, an extra 100 numbers or so, that they shouldn't have. We also see that various people of other political parties, other political representatives, like the Communist Party or whoever they sent, could also be in the act. Of course, not all of them, but the ones that are put in certain departments by the regime to also see that this fraud of votes happens with the presiding judge. Obviously, the regime knows how to steal votes from the people. It's practiced this for many years now, and it's also obviously been trained for many years to do this and to steal votes from the people and exaggerate the results that we see on our television screens from the Ministry of Interior. Let's go to another video now, another tactic of the regime where the results can be tampered with before they reach the first instance court. Let's go to that video.
Την κάλπη μέχρι το πρωτοδικείο τα έγγραφα λιώνονται. Ποιος το ελέγχει αυτό? Η δικαστική αντιπρόσωπος λοιπόν μπορεί να λιώσει το χαρτί της, να αλλάξει τα αποτελέσματα και να στείλει όποιο χαρτί θέλει και οτιδήποτε αποτέλεσμα θέλει μέσα στο πρωτοδικείο. Σωστά?
Ναι. Σωστά.
Ωραία. Συμβαίνει. Συμβαίνει σε όσα γουστάρουν αυτοί με τους δικούς τους ανθρώπους. Δεν συμβαίνει σε όλα, συμβαίνει. Σε κλέβει και από εκεί. Άρα καλώς ψήφισε, καλώς υπόγραψε ο δικαστικός αντιπρόσωπος. Πολύ ωραία. Έλα να βρεις άκρη. Έλα να αποδείξεις εσύ ότι σε έκλεψα. Ενώ θα φύγει μέσα και θα πάει. Ότι δεν ψηφίσανε 250, ψηφίσανε 375 και θα βάλει τους σταυρούς όπως θέλει αυτή. Άρα δίνει το χαρτί της μέσα.
So here we see that the presiding judge can also tamper with the results. And let's also see this article here, which actually, this is an occurrence that happened where envelopes, the results of the ballot box goes into an envelope which has to be specifically sealed. Now, in this article, in certain districts, these envelopes didn't have the specific seal, so this allows the presiding judge to tamper with the results before it goes to the first instance court. And this happens, could happen often. As Artemis says, it might not happen often, but it does happen, and further results are exaggerated. That's why we have such a big number at the end through the Ministry of Interior. Now, we're going to go to another video that regards the political parties, and we're going to analyse the political party involvement in all this fraud process of the national elections and any elections that Greece has. Let's go to the next video.
Δεν έχει να κάνει μόνο να ελέγξουμε τα δικά μας ποσοστά που μας κλέβουν. Έχει να κάνει και με ένα μεγάλο κομμάτι που αυτοί κρέμονται σε μια κλωστή. Και δεν είναι κόμματα, δεν υπάρχουν κόμματα και ιδεολογίες. Είναι οι ίδιοι άνθρωποι που αλλάζουν ρούχα. Είναι το ίδιο το αυτό που αλλάζει η ρούχα και πάει από το ένα κόμμα στο άλλο. Ποσοστό της Χρυσής Αυγής που είναι. Πουθενά δεν είναι ρε παιδιά. Δεν ψήφισαν οι Χρυσοί Αυγητές. Μα και Χρυσή Αυγή με το ίδιο σύστημα είχε βγει. Μα και ο Λεβέντης που είχε 5% κοινά γήπαρδες με το ίδιο σύστημα είχε βγει. Του δώσανε ψήφους από τα δικό τους τα τμήματα. Συν την αποχή τη μεγάλη. Είδες ένα βλαμμένο με 5% να σου λέει και δεν έχει ούτε 5 ψήφους. Τι να σου πει, γιατί ψηφίστηκε, γιατί. Για το στάτους του πολιτικό, για το παρουσιαστικό του, για αυτά που έλεγε που δεν έλεγε τίποτα. Για σκεφτείτε το. Γι' αυτό και βλέπετε και ξεφουσκώνουν όλα αυτά. Και τελείως. Το ποτάμι πώς μπήκε. Είχε 5% το ποτάμι. Ή τελικά είχε 5% ο Μπαρουφάκης. γιατί έκανε τη μεγάλη εκστρατεία και είπε πολύ σοβαρά πράγματα και τον αγάπησε ο λαός και τον ψήφισε. Που τον ψήφισε αυτό ότι όχι, είχε και ένα τραβεστή 60 χρονών. Που έλεγε ο Μέγας Αλέξανδρος είναι μπουρδέλο. Από πού να ψηφιστεί ρε παλικάρια, δεν χρειάζεται να τον ψηφίσει κανείς. Το σύστημα αυτό ψηφίζει και βγάζει αυτούς που θέλει. Ότι όλο αυτό το καθεστώς έχει παντού τα πλοκτάμια του και σε κλέβει συνεχώς. Ήδη είδαμε στην Τολεμαΐδα, δεν ξέρω θυμάμαι πού.
Στην Τολεμαΐδα, σωστά. Στην Τολεμαΐδα, ρε
πρόεδρε. Δικαστικό, εκλογικό αντιπρόσωπο να ψηφίσει του κοινάλ, να βάζει σταυρούς στη Νέα Δημοκρατία. Το οξύμορο το αντιλαμβάνεστε.
Έτσι ακριβώς, αρχηγέ. Και σε πόσα άλλα μέρη, σε πόσα άλλα εκλογικά τμήματα έγινε ακριβώς το ίδιο, είτε με το κοινάλ, είτε με του ΚΚ, είτε με οποιοδήποτε άλλου που βάζανε και σταυρώνανε τη Νέα Δημοκρατία, γιατί αυτή ήταν η εντολή σε αυτές τις εκλογές να γίνει αυτό.
Σωστά. Βλέπετε τώρα, επειδή πιάστηκε ένα, άλλα 10.000 περιστατικά και 20.000 περιστατικά δεν πιάστηκαν. Δηλαδή να καταλάβετε, η Κωνσταντοπούλου έχει κάνει, ποιο κόμμα έχει κάνει η Αλέξανδρε?
Την Πλεύση Ελευθερίας.
Ωραία. Η οποία πήρε 1,9%.
1,4.
1,4. Πήρε 1,4. Δεν έχει καμία εμφάνιση πουθενά. Δεν έχει πει τίποτα. Βγήκε και λέει όλοι είμαστε γκέι και όλοι μαζί θα πάμε και όλα καλά. Δεν είπε τίποτα. Δεν έχει οργάνωση. Δεν έχει τίποτα η κοπέλα. Λοιπόν, και πήρε 1,4. Η Ελλήνων Συνέλευση που έχει 400 γραφεία που σημαίνει όσα έχουν όλα τα κόμματα μαζί, εμείς έχουμε παραπάνω τουλάχιστον 100. Δηλαδή όσα έχει ο ΣΥΡΙΖΑ. Ο ΣΥΡΙΖΑ έχει γύρω στα 56. Η Νέα Δημοκρατία, κάτι δικηγόρη και κάτι αυτή, εκτός από τα κεντρικά της. Δεν έχουν τίποτα. Εσύ που είσαι παντού, είσαι ο μόνος που έχεις κάνει στατικές δράσεις, είσαι ο μόνος που κάνεις δράση και κινείσαι παντού, είσαι ο μόνος που έχεις κάνει τόσο τεράστια οργάνωση και πραγματικά αγώνα. Αυτοί δεν έχουν κάνει τίποτα, σαφώς έχουν άλλα αυτοί, και βλέπεις ότι εσύ παίρνεις 0,5 ή 0,25. Αυτό είναι για να σου δώσουν μία φάπα να σπάσουν να σπάσει το ηθικό σου. Δηλαδή, ξανακατεβαίνετε, δηλαδή πάτε και σε εθνικές εκλογές. Μπράβο, πάρε ένα 0,25. Εσύ δεν έχεις τη δυνατότητα τώρα, εφόσον δεν έχεις το μηχανισμό τον προηγούμενο που σου είπα να τον ελέγξεις. Ό,τι σου πούνε ανέφαλες. Γιατί πρέπει να έχουμε στοιχεία για να κάνουμε ένσταση και για να τσακίσουμε όλο αυτό το μηχανισμό.
So from this video one can conclude that all political parties are actually one and they all conspire in choosing which party they want in government and they want as a winner or which parties they want in the parliament. We see that Golden Dawn is now non-existent in parliament and it's quite questionable as to where all their voters went. Now, one could assume that they entered the parliament in the last elections. Maybe they entered the parliament through the same procedure. That's quite evident that their numbers were initially inflated because the system and the regime chooses who they want in the parliament. And all of a sudden, we see that Golden Dawn has lost its members and has pretty much no numbers. There is no way that Golden Dawn members would have voted for any other parties, really. They wouldn't have voted for the Communist Party. They wouldn't have voted for New Democracy. So it's questionable as to where the votes went or if there were any votes in the first place. We also see some other pretty much non-existent political leaders, such as Leventis with 1.24% as opposed to 5%. We also see Konstantopoulou with 1.4% with her party, and these are people that are pretty much non-existent in the political scene and who have had no actions on the streets or have had no political campaign to account for the amounts they received. We also see that the Potami in previous elections got a 5%, which the Potami as well was a non-existent back then. So we see that the regime is directly involved in the counting the numbers and fixing the numbers so it goes to the political parties that they want. Now, if we compare the actions and the political campaigns of these people to ELLINON SYNELEYSIS, we see that ELLINON SYNELEYSIS, with over 430 officers and with over 400 parliamentarians all around Greece campaigning for ELLINON SYNELEYSIS, we see that they give us a result of 0.2%, which is quite, which is probably can exist according to the actions and the campaigns we did compared to the other political parties. So there's definitely been a robbery of our results, and we will actually see this in further along in the program, where we actually show evidence from the first instance courts and the Ministry of Interior, and we compare these results on how they stole votes from ELLINON SYNELEYSIS. Now, another important issue to mention is the abstention. The abstention in these elections was definitely over 60%, even though the media shows that it is 40%. Now, the media and the political regime will never show over 50% abstention, because that is when the government has actually, the government would then be abolished, over 50%. But the results actually show a 60% abstention rate. Now, of course, this is also obviously because of the summer period, where many people didn't vote. The abstention, unfortunately, goes in favour of the regime, because you have less people voting, and you have pretty much the 40% of the population that votes for the regime and people that are in the regime, whereas the 60% who are people who have fed up with the system and they just don't want any action in the voting process of their country. We also see another political figure, Varoufakis, and with his political party Mera 25, and it's important to mention that we showed Varoufakis the balance sheet, a balance sheet of the country, which shows the 600 billion in these accounts. Now, and he actually said that it was a fraudulent document publicly, even though it's got a number, even though it's got a seal that it is fake, that it is a legit government gazette. Varoufakis, of course, was in Syriza. He was the economics minister during Syriza's time. And we see that all political politicians are pretty much recycled people that go around from political party to the other. We see that Syriza actually consists of people from New Democracy. It consists of people from PASOK. And we see that people just change their positions according to what the system wants. We also see that Artemis Sorras refers to a transvestite within Varoufakis' political party that defames and insults Alexander the Great. And she actually did this quite negatively against Alexander the Great. And it shows the status of the political parties and what sort of people are actually governing our country. Let's go to actually a document where we will also show how the political parties help each other and are all in on the act. Now, this is, let's put this article up. It's actually a political party called Movement of Change, which is the PASOK, that's in Parliament today. A political representative of that party was caught putting votes towards New Democracy. Now, this proves again that the political parties are all one, and it's obviously a strategy put in place by the regime in order for now New Democracy to win. Now, this is just one case of a political representative caught. Of course, there would be hundreds of other cases where the same thing occurs, where political representatives of other political parties put votes towards New Democracy and whoever they wanted as a winner. So all political parties are in on the fraud. We also see actually the existence of a new political figure, Velopoulos, and his new political party called Greek Solution. And now that we're talking about political status, let's have a bit of a look at Velopoulos now. Now, if we haven't seen enough fools already in Greek Parliament, this guy has got to take the cherry on the cake, because this person has a TV channel selling books and certain ridiculous products. And on top of all these ridiculous products, he actually claims that he's the only person on the planet that has handwritten epistles of Jesus Christ. Now, this is quite ridiculous in itself, and a person from the ministry has actually sued him for saying these lies. These are the sort of people we actually have in our government. Now, we're going to go to another example where the political parties are involved in the act, and we're actually going to go to a video regarding the Communist Party of our country, of Greece, and their involvement in the national elections, and as well as their involvement in the voting processes through throughout the years. Let's go to that video.
Πάνω σε αυτό που λες αρχηγέ, πάντως είδαμε και το παγιωμένο 5% του κουκουέ, που σε αυτές τις εκλογές εμφανίστηκε με άλλους 3 ή 4 κομματικούς μηχανισμούς και το 5% ήταν σταθερό. Δεν έσπασε και δεν διαλύθηκε τίποτα. Λες και τα κομμουνιστές που ψάχνουν να βρουν μια άλλη ταυτότητα για να εμφανιστούν.
Πολύ σωστά, γιατί δεν ήταν μόνο το ΚΚ που κατέβηκε σε αυτές τις εκλογές, ήταν και οι τορκτσιστές, ήταν και το
μαρξιστικό-λενιστικό,
ήταν 5 διαφορετικά κόμματα του ΚΚ όλα, τα οποία δεν πήρανε από το Κομμουνιστικό Κόμμα ούτε μία ψήφο.
Μα το Κομμουνιστικό Κόμμα, το 5% αυτό που βλέπετε, είναι δικό του. Και δεν θα αλλάξει και δεν έχει αλλάξει. Κινείται ανάμεσα 3,5, 5, 6, εκεί κινείται συνεχώς. Με τα παρακλάδια τα δικά του. Αυτή είναι η δυναμική του. Και είναι αληθινή των Ελλήνων. Είναι ψεύτικη.
Να θυμηθούμε και το ΣΥΡΙΖΑ που ήταν στο ΚΚ.
Ναι, δικό την παρακλάδι είναι στο ΚΚ, βέβαια.
Πάντως έχει σημειωθεί στις μέρες μας από ανθρώπους του Κομμουνιστικού Κόμματος. Από όταν πρώτο είπες ότι το 5% είναι παγιωμένο και ήδη τώρα κάθεται στις συνειδήσεις των ανθρώπων, αναρωτιούνται ακόμα και ήδη πώς ακριβώς είναι αυτό το 5% παγιωμένο. Δηλαδή έχει περάσει και εσωτερικά στο μηχανισμό. Γιατί ναι, μεν κομμουνιστής, αλλά είναι και άνθρωπος. Κάπου έχει και νόηση.
Έχει, εδώ είναι το θέμα. Το ΚΚ από όταν γεννήθηκε, άμα το θέλετε, στην Ελλάδα, με Εβραίο τον Μπεναρόγια, η συμφωνία και με, και με τη Ρωσία αλλά και με τις Ηνωμένες Πολιτείες, Ανατολή και Δύση, ήταν ότι δεν θα πάει ποτέ πάνω από 7% και ποτέ κάτω από 3%. Δηλαδή η συμφωνία ήταν ότι το ΚΚ θα είναι πάντα μέσα στη Βουλή. Αυτή ήταν η συμφωνία. Είναι έγγραφη αυτή η συμφωνία.
Now, according to this video, we actually see some mind-blowing information that Artemis Sorras has revealed regarding the Communist Party of Greece, KUKUE, and in regards to its establishment in Greece and the agreements for it to operate within Greece and its general agreement. In these national elections of 2019, we see that the Communist Party actually breaks up into 5 different divisions. And as mentioned, we see that it breaks up into the Trotskyists, the Marxist-Lenin Party, and some other parties. Now, even though it was divided, we still see the exact same percentages for the Communist Party KUKUE, which is always around the 3-5% mark. And now, as Artemis Sorras mentions, this is because this has actually been predetermined by an agreement on the Communist Party, an agreement between Russia and America on how the Communist Party is to operate and how it is to operate in Greece, so that it is always inside Parliament with a 3-5% result. Again, we see like the establishment of the Communist Party was established by Abraham Ben Aroya of Jewish origin, again Jewish interests in our country. And the influence of Jews and their institutions in Greece. Let's also go to some photos as well. Let's see some photos regarding Liana Kaneli and Dora Bakoyani. So we're talking about two totally different political parties in ideologies. On the left, we see Liana Kaneli, a member of the Communist Party. And on the right, we see Dora Bakoyani. Dora Bakoyani is Kyriakos Mitsotakis' sister, who is part of New Democracy. And they seem to be one happy family within the parliament. This was after the oath they took after the 2019 elections. So, in essence, we actually see a recycling of politicians from one party to the other. We see that New Democracy voted, puts a PASOK member, his name is Michalis Chrysochoidis, as the Minister of Citizen Protection. And this person was actually criticized by Mitsotakis last year for the fires at Mati, which killed a lot of Greek citizens. We see that he reinstates him as the Minister of Political and Citizen Protection. Of course, as mentioned before, Syriza contains members of New Democracy and PASOK. And let's not also forget the scandals that these political parties are involved in, because we see that Dora Bakoyani, which we saw in the photos, her daughter was involved in a scandal within the Red Cross where she was earning over 320,000 euros per year in a non-for-profit organization, the Red Cross. Of course, if we see as well Liana Kaneli, if we are to see her home, it's a huge mansion. and we see the great as a we see her great we see that she's a great role model of communism with this mansion, of course. As we also Dora Bakogiani also had her own political party some years ago against New Democracy, and now we see her part of New Democracy once again with her brother Kyriakos Mitsotakis in governance. Let's go now to this is probably a next section which involves some results and very important results of ELLINON SYNELEYSIS in the district of Serres. Now the district of Serres is where Calliope was the political representative, and the political representatives and the political candidates of Serres went to the first instance court to ask for their results as opposed to what the Ministry of Interior showed on the TV, on the channels, and what they promoted as our results. Let's have a look at these results. Now this is, there's three different results up here. It shows the fake results of the Ministry of Interior compared to the results of the Ministry of the First Instance Court. And I'm going to go through the names of ELLINON SYNELEYSIS parliamentarian candidates and the varying results between these documents. So first we have Leonidas Almasidis. The Ministry of Interior, in other words Singular Logic, because Singular Logic counts the votes, but before giving it to Ministry of Interior, we see that he has 23 votes to his name, as opposed to the First Instance Court, which shows that he has 58 votes to his name, which is a difference of 35 votes. The next parliamentarian is Elias Georgiadis, 26 as opposed to 133 votes, with a difference of 107 missing votes. Then we see Alexandros Zagelidis with 25 votes as compared to 97 votes of the First Instance Court, with a difference of 72 missing votes. Then we see Anatoly Kotsaridou, 16 votes as opposed to 44 votes of the First Instance Court, a difference of 28 votes missing that are missing. Sultana Naum, 6 votes as opposed to 30 votes of the First Instance Court, that's a difference of 24 votes. And we see also Didzios Stergios with 33 votes from the Ministry of Interior that was promoted to 137 votes of the First Instance Court, that's a difference of 104 votes. So the total sum of missing votes for this district of Serres amounts to 370 missing votes. If we add up the amount that the Ministry of Interior reported, altogether it equals 129, and the true results should have been 499 altogether. Now if we are to average the votes of the missing votes of each candidate, we would see an average of 61 votes per candidate, if we are to the average between these six parliamentarians. Now if we are to times 61 votes with all the parliamentarians around Greece of ELLINON SYNELEYSIS, that's 61 times 400 parliamentarian candidates of ELLINON SYNELEYSIS, and that equals 24,000 missing votes, and it's probably even more than that. So who is going to account for these missing votes? Of course, once these results were received by the candidates in Serres, that then a lot of objections were made all over Greece with candidates of ELLINON SYNELEYSIS in many areas of Greece. They asked for the same results from the First Instance Court and were denied the results. A lot of questions being raised there as well. Now one could also say or assume that this also lowers the morale of the people within ELLINON SYNELEYSIS, and we see that if Didzios Stergios was to see, or any other member was to see the very low votes from the Ministry of Interior, they would say that their own people didn't even vote for them, whereas they actually received more, with a difference of 60 votes more than what the First Instance, the Ministry of Interior showed. Now, this is probably the most hands-on that we can show. We're going to go to some other stats involving these national elections, and these stats include that people, our political representatives in the departments, were still counting votes while the channels had already declared the winner. This happened at 7 p.m. because 7 p.m. is when the ballots close. Just after 7 p.m. the results are already in, and at 7:30 p.m. the governance is already announced. Now this can't happen because in order to count the crosses alone for each parliamentarian, this takes in its own 20 to 30 days to count. That's just the crosses. And therefore, we can conclude that the results of ELLINON SYNELEYSIS should be much higher than 0.2%. Now we're going to go to another point in our program where we're going to show the solution to this problem and how the citizen himself will be able to monitor and check the next national elections. Let's go to the next video, which is the solution ELLINON SYNELEYSIS provides.
Πει από την αρχή ότι πρέπει να συσταθεί ο μηχανισμός και το έχω πει ακόμα και όταν δεν είχαμε την ΕΣΥ από πολύ παλιά, ότι ο πολίτης θα πρέπει να ελέγξει τις εκλογές. Για να ελέγξουμε τις εκλογές μας χρειαζόμαστε όσα εκλογικά τμήματα είναι τόσους εκλογικούς αντιπροσώπους, πραγματικά εκπαιδευμένους, τα μάτια τους να κοιτάνε και να μην φύγουν ούτε μία ώρα από το εκλογικό τμήμα. Να ελέγξουμε τις εκλογές μας χρειαζόμαστε 22.000 άτομα εκλογικούς αντιπροσώπους, 250 ανθρώπους τουλάχιστον που θα μπουν στα πρωτοδικεία να πάρουν τα έγγραφα των δικαστικών αντιπροσώπων και 300 άτομα σε βάση δεδομένων, να είμαστε σε μια βάση δεδομένων όλων υπολογιστών για να περνάμε από το σύστημά μας όλα τα αποτελέσματα και να τα συγκρίνουμε, να κάνουμε αντιπαραθέσεις. Και φυσικά να δώσουμε και 50.000 να φέρουμε και ένα τον ποτηρίτη. Άρα λοιπόν εκεί χρειαζόμαστε άλλη μια ομάδα, όπως έχω πει, για να ελέγξουμε όλη αυτή τη διαδικασία. Και στο τέλος όλη η βάση δεδομένων ελέγχει τους ψήφους. Εκεί θέλω τον ποτηρίτη. Θέλω τον ποτηρητή για να έχει βάση η διαδικασία της ένστασης που θα κάνω, γιατί θα την κάνεις και στον ΟΗΕ. Έχουν μόνο ένα μονόδρομο να οργανώσουν την ίδια την Ελλάδα, την ΕΛΛΗΝΟΝ ΣΥΝΕΛΕΦΣΗ και τον ανθρωποκεντρικό μηχανισμό της ΕΛΛΗΝΟΝ ΣΥΝΕΛΕΦΣΗΣ, όπου ο πόλεμος θα πάει πιο παγκόσμιος. Τώρα είμαστε εδώ. Αλλά πρέπει να εκτελέσεις το εδώ. Το θέμα είναι να καταλάβετε ότι τελειώνουν τα κόμματα. Δεν έχουν κάτι άλλο να κάνουν. Και εκεί πρέπει να είμαστε πιο δυνατοί για να εισπράξουμε και τον κόσμο. Και φυσικά πρέπει να αλλάξουμε και τη συνείδηση του κόσμου. Εμείς.
So this video shows us the solution to the problem that of the regime counting and exaggerating the results of the national elections, not just the 2019, but all elections from the time the ballot box was originated in 1833 and onwards. Breaking down this solution, in regards to monitoring the next national elections, the political representatives must equal the number of departments that exist. So if this is 20,000 departments, we have to have representatives that equal that amount. Now, these people, the political representatives, are the basis and the foundation for all of the monitoring process that will happen thereafter. Their job is to remain in the department at all times and strictly oversee everything that happens in the department to make sure that the preceding judge who is allocated, as I say once again, by the regime and by the bar association, to make sure no extra votes are placed in the ballot box secretly. And of course, to monitor other things such as name tags, as Calliope mentioned previously, regarding other political representatives, and that to make sure they're not breaching their duties. Their job in the end is to verify the results once the votes are counted within each department, and send these results off to ELLINON SYNELEYSIS, and these results must match the results that are received by the first instance courts by the preceding judge. Let's go now to the people that we must have at the first instance courts. These amount to maybe around 250 people, depending on the amount of first instance courts. As I said, these results at the first instance courts must match the results that the political representatives counted at the end of the voting process in the departments. That's how you will catch out the preceding judge to make sure that they didn't tamper with the results from the department to the first instance court. The first instance courts will also catch out the hidden departments, and this is because they will receive the extra 500 or up to 1,000 they will receive 1,000 extra results, which are the departments themselves. But in order to catch this out, you have to have your basis, which is your political representatives in all of the departments. So that way you know how many departments there are and how many hidden departments there are extra. Now we go to what Artemis Sorras mentions as the 300 databases. These are located within ELLINON SYNELEYSIS itself and the headquarters of ELLINON SYNELEYSIS, and their job is to cross-reference the results with singular logic for any irregularities. Now, if there are any irregularities in the numbers, this is where the UN observer plays his role, as Artemis Sorras mentions, and any objections will be taken to the United Nations. As long as there is solid ground and evidence to back up this to back up the objection, and this is why you need, of course, the political representatives in every department, as well as your first instance court people. And this will expose the whole election system. Of course, we can't object within Greece because there is no mechanism of the state that rightfully and justfully performs its duty, because all the mechanisms of Greece are part of this same system, is part of the same system that Otto Brain from back then. And through ELLINON SYNELEYSIS, we see that only ELLINON SYNELEYSIS gives the active role of the citizen to monitor his own election process. And this is the rightful duty in the end of the Hellene citizen, and he has to play an active role in the voting process as well as his whatever the community is needed of him. This is what an active citizen's duty is. We see that ELLINON SYNELEYSIS is now active with 400 parliamentarian candidates all over Greece, informing people right up until the next elections. Now, the important thing of this program of Hellenes Uniting is to create awareness for the people abroad, because this program, of course, is in English, and the mindset of people abroad is what has to change, because many people abroad think that the Hellenes themselves, the Greeks, are responsible for the political parties that come about as a result of their voting and the election process. Whereas through this program, we saw that the evidence shows otherwise, and that the results are tampered with, the results are also exaggerated, and we see great amounts and votes that are actually counted by people that are deceased. And the whole political spectrum is involved in this, all political parties are involved in this cover-up, and even the state mechanisms are involved in this cover-up. Artemis Sorras says that this will probably happen within a year's time, because this current government won't last. Of course, the government will put in all these measures that it has put in for so many times, including 7-day working week, including higher taxes for the people, lower income, constantly taking their homes, squalor, people living in poverty, high unemployment rates. This is all the only thing the government has done for so many years. And this will lead to great sporadic actions by the government in order to destroy Greece once and for all, which is what they want and what is what their ultimate goal is. Artemis Sorras in the video refers to that these two elections, both the Euro elections and the national elections, were never ours. That's why they happened so close together as well. And that the next elections must and will be ours. And in order for this to happen, there is this global call with many programs that we're doing throughout within ELLINON SYNELEYSIS, and this program as well in English for people abroad, to research the facts of ELLINON SYNELEYSIS, see the purpose and the purpose of this battle, and the purpose of this battle is to unite Hellenes all around the world, exposing the matrix and offering the solution out of it. And the solution, of course, is through the many economic tools that Artemis has brought. He's revealed the matrix involving the heritage funds, involving the election process, as we are mentioning today. It's based on the true awakening of the human being, because the human being has unfortunately lost his way and is living within this matrix, where not only the voting procedure of Greece is fixed, but the voting procedure of all around the world is also fixed, and people can see this. People can feel the injustice. They see that it's the same political parties everywhere around the world. We have to take a role. We have to take an active role, and ELLINON SYNELEYSIS gives the opportunity, and it's the legal representation of the nation, of the citizen himself, to monitor his national elections in the next elections. Therefore, become active in the unification of the Hellenes all over the planet take an active stance and research what ELLINON SYNELEYSIS is all about. And we actually have our email down on the bottom of the screen. Contact us, become involved, ask any questions you want, research the facts yourselves, and don't take everything we say for just for the hell of it. Research the facts and become active in this unification of Hellenes all around the planet. Thank you for watching the program, Hellenes Uniting. And then I'm enforced to everybody. We'll do more programs with involving more things of ELLINON SYNELEYSIS and uncovering the matrix. Then I'm enforced to everybody, and thank you for watching.